فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
So the hadith now moved from what level? From sahih to what? Hasan. Whilst I'm on that note, the same ruling that the hadith which is Hasanul Lidati took is a speech that Imam al-Iraqi rahimahullah he said. When he defined it, he said, وَالْحَسَنُ الْمَعْرُوفُ مَخْرَجًا وَقَدْ اِشْتَهَرَتْ رِجَالُهُ بِذَاكَ حَدْ حد وقال ترمذي ما سلم من الشذوذ معرو متهم بكذب ولم يكن فرد ورد قلت وقد حسان بعض من فرد وقيل ما ضعف قريب محتمل فيهما وما بكل ذا حد حصل. عراقي رحمه الله سيد الحسن المعروف مخرجا وقد اشتهرت رجاله بذاك حد. This definition, Iraqi took is whose definition? It's the definition of who? The definition of the hadith هو ما عرف مخرجه واشتهر رجاله is خطاب التعريف. You see, that's what خطاب said. حد وقال الترمذي, and الترمذي said the last part, which is ما سلم من الشذوذ مع راو متهم بذاك ولم يكن فرد ورد قلت وقد حسن بعض من فرد وقيل ما ضعف قريب محتمل فيه وما بكل ذا حد حصل. مراتبه, the levels of حسن. Remember when we spoke about the Hassan, what did we say, the Sahih? We said that the Sahih has levels, right? Mm-hmm. We did. We said it's maratib, levels that are different. The Hassan al-Lidati is also the same. And Imam al-Zahabi, rahimahullah, Imam al-Zahabi, he mentions that the levels they are. In his Kitab al-Muqidha, Zahabi is the one who mentions it. He says it's two types. It's two levels, sorry. The first level is فَأَعْلَى مَرَاتِبُ. The highest of the level is مَخْتُلِفَ فِي تَصْحِيحِ حَدِيثِ رُوَاتِهِ وَتَحْسِينِ. The first one is the hadith in which the scholars have disagreement whether the narrator here is a authentic narrator or if he's a Hassan narrator. Is he a Sahih narrator or is he a Hassan narrator? That one is the highest. Such as who? كَحَدِيثِ بَهْزُ بْنُ حَكِيمٍ عَنْ أَبِيهِ عَنْ جَدِّهِ وَعَمْرُ بْنُ شُعَيْبٍ. That, like the hadith of who? بَهْزُ بْنُ حَكِيمٍ, who narrated from his father, who narrated from his grandfather. Such as also like what? The hadith of Amr ibn Shu'ayb, who narrated from his father, who great from his grandfather. Wa ibn Ishaq, also the narration of Ibn Ishaq, and it taymiyu, and other than that, there's dispute. Some they say sahih, some they say Hassan. The second one is ma ba'da dhalika, that which is lower than it. And what is it? Makhtulifa fi tahsini hadith ruwati wa tad'ifi. The scholars are in dispute of what? Whether this narrator is Hassan or Da'if. There's that pull and push in on him. Such as the hadith of Harith ibn Abdullah, and the hadith of who? Asim ibn Damrata, wa Hajjaj ibn Ardat, and other than them. There's some who say they're Hassan hadith, some they say no, they're weak hadiths, and there's that debate that keeps coming up. And then Hafiz ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, after that he said, wa bi kathrati turuqihi yusahha. We've taken Hassan, have we not? What was the last thing you just said, brothers? I don't get it.
Two points.
Before I move on to the next point of Ibn Hajar's speech, I have to mention this, which is an Imam al-Baghawi, rahimahullah, the great Imam, Imam al-Baghawi, rahimahullah, who has a book called Al-Masabih. He has a book called مصابيح السنة. It's called مصابيح. It's a book in which he compiles a hadith which are in Bukhari, the four أصحاب السنن, which is the six books, six mothers, Bukhari, Muslim, Abi Dawud, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Al-Nasai, and also Sunan al-Darami. Sunan al-Darami. So all this hadith, he took it, rahimahullah, and he basically worked on it. Came after him Al-Khatib al-Tibrizi, rahimahullah, he also organized it more. He called it Mishkat al-Masabih. Sheikh al-Albani put his pen on it. Ala kulli hal, the point is, Al-Imam al-Baghawi, rahimahullah, he did something in his Masabih. he brought a definition uniquely for him, رحمه الله, which he says, وأنه يرمز إلى الأحاديث التي في الصحيحين أو أحدهما بقوله. He comes to the صحيحين, a hadith which is in Bukhari and Muslim. So what did he do? He puts next to it a sign which he says صحيح. Bukhari Muslim, صحيح. If the hadith is narrated in the four books, Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, and Nasa'i, what does he do? He writes Hassan. As though he's trying to say that the hadith which are in Bukhari are called Sahih, and the hadith which are in the four other books are called Hassan. And that Hassan is unique for the four books, and that the two books, Bukhari and Muslim, it's the hadith are in it are called Sahih. ولذلك Iraqi refuted him this before him, Amr ibn Salah did. He said, والبغوي إذ قسم مصابح إلى الصحاح والحسان جانحة أن الحسان ما رووه في السنن ردى عليه إذ بها غير الحسن. And this is sometimes some people, they have this belief which is لا مشاحة في الصلاح. It's no problem, brother, with definitions and terminologies. No problem. لا مشاحة في الصلاح. نعم, there is. It's not, this word is not at its open. Bukhari can have a hadith which is حسن. And he can have a hadith which is صحيح. So Nabi Dawood, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Nasa'i can have Hassan. And they can have Sahih. Like Bukhari, the hadith which he has that are Hassan, are a hadith which are Hassan لذاته كثرت طرقه. Its chains became more and it reached a level where it now called صحيح لغيره. Pay attention, which we're going to come to now. This type of Hassan that a person wants to research and wants to see and, you know, I want to learn. Huh? How does he find it, or where does he find it? Where can one find these? The books you can find the hadith which are Hassan is Jami' al-Tirmidhi, which is well known for Sunan al-Tirmidhi. It's very well known for Hassan al-Hadith. And I ask everybody to really focus on the new publication that's come out regarding the six books, other than Sunan Abi Dawood hasn't come out yet. But Dar al-Ta'seel. Dar al-Ta'seel have the best publication now so far out there regarding Bukhari, Muslim, Tirmidhi, Mustadrak al-Hakim, and Ibn Majah, Al-Muntaqa al-Ibn Jar. They're the best. They should try to get that type of publication. It's called Dar al-Ta'seel. Naam. So make sure that you rely on a nuskha, muhaqqaqa, munaqqaha, mu'tamada, according to the scholars, take that one. The second place that you find a hadith which are Hassan are Sunan Abi Dawood. Sunan Abi Dawood, and as I said before, Abu Dawood rahimahullah, he has a risala, a letter in which he wrote to the people of Mecca, explaining his book and what he's, the way he wrote his book. Huh? And the way he wrote his book. And that he mentions in that letter that any ahadith which are in his book which are weak, that he will mention that. And any ahadith which he's quiet about, and that he didn't criticize it or didn't praise it, he went about silent it. فَوَ صَالِحٌ, that it's a good hadith. So if we find generally a hadith, generally speaking, there are some points, some ahadith that can be looked into, but generally speaking, if Abu Dawood is quiet about a hadith, generally he sees it to be salih, good. Daraqutni as well. Sunan al-Daraqutni. Imam al-Daraqutni has a sunan. He also is a book where you would go to. Is min madhannat al-Hasan. It's from the books you would go to in hadith which are Hasan. Brothers, Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he says, وَبِكَثْرَةِ طُرُقِهِ يُصَحَّحُ. Ibn Hajar rahimahullah is saying, وَبِكَثْرَةِ طُرُقِهِ يُصَحَّحُ. What's he referring to? Ibn Hajar is trying to say to you, حسن لذاتي plus حسن لذاتي equals صحيح لغيري. How works? Simple. Correct? حسن لذاتي, حسن لذاتي, now becomes, all together becomes what? It becomes صحيح لغيري. That's it. الحسن لذاتي إذا روي من طريق آخر مثله أو أقوى منه. With what condition? Two conditions, بارك الله فيكم. If حسن لذاتي is narrated in another chain of narration, that other chain of narration has to either be the same as it, meaning another حسن لذاته, or if it's what? If it's صحيح لذاته, and this is a حسن لذاته, it helps it. Now it becomes صحيح لغيري, the other one. Pay attention. The example that is given generally for this one is as Imam al-Iraqi rahimahullah mentioned, والحسن المشهور بالعدالة والصدق راوي والصدق راويه والصدق راويه إذا أتى له طرق أخرى نحوها من الطرق. Sorry. والحسن المشهور بالعدالة والصدق راويه إذا أتى له طرق أخرى نحوها من الطرق صححته كمتني لولا أن أشق اتابعوا محمد بن عمرو عليه فارتقى الصحيح يجري. Iraqi rahimahullah is talking about the hadith narrated by Al-Imam Tirmidhi rahimahullah in Kitab al-Tahara, Babu Maja'a fi Siwaki. He says, Muhammad ibn Amr, who narrated from An-Abi Salamah to An-Abi Hurairah, Anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, lawla ana shuq ala ummati la amartum bis siwaki inda kulli salah. In this hadith, there's a man by the name of Amr ibn Muhammad ibn Amr ibn Al-Qamata. He is from the one of the people who are known for what? المشهورين بالصدق والسيانة, known for his truthfulness and his goodness. لكنه لم يكن من أهل الإتقان. But he is not a person who is what? Who is solid in the hadith. حتى ضعفه بعضهم. Some scholars even weakened him. من جهة سوء حفظه. And this issue comes from his memory. ووثقه بعضهم. And some of them have what they've done. They helped him. لصدقي وجلالتي. Because of his truthfulness and his nobility. فحديث من هذه الجهة حسن. When we look at it from face value from there, this hadith is now become حسن لغيره. This is the weak. فلما انضم إلى ذلك كونه روية أن أوجه أخر زال بذلك ما كنا نخشاه عليه من جهة سوء حفظه. Since there came other narrations and it supported this narration, then what happens is what we were scared of, which was what Muhammad ibn Amr ibn Al-Qama would say. Maybe we'd say, oh, he got it wrong. Maybe it's his memory. He got this one wrong. We're not worried anymore. Why? Because other narrations are here to support him. So now we're going to say, this is the times he gets it right. He's right this time. There's nothing wrong with him. You see, that which we were scared of in terms of his memory has now been removed, alhamdulillah. وانجبر به ذلك النقص اليسير. And that slight deficiency has now been cured and helped. فصح هذا الإسناد. Now this hadith has become صحيح. والتحق بدرجة الصحيح. And has now gone into the realm of صحيح. And that's what I said. Iraqi said, والحسن المشهور بالعدالة والصدق راويه إذا أتى له طرق أخرى نحوها من الطرق صححته كمثلي لولا أنا شق اتابعوا محمد بن عمرو عليه فارتقى الصحيح يجري. Iraqi said in his ألفية. So that is when the hadith is حسن لغيره with another حسن لغيره there comes حسن لغيره with other hadith which are صحيح. It supports it, it pushes it up, as Amr ibn Salah al-Iraqi rahimahumullah, they said. Naam. So what we said here right now is that the hadith which is hasanu lidati, with another hasanu lidati, it becomes sahihu li ghayri. Or any hadith which is higher than hasanu lidatihi, coming with the hasanu lidati, will also push it to sahihu li ghayri. Is that understood? The example I gave was the hadith of Abu Huraira, where the Prophet ﷺ said, if I did not fear hardship or I did not want hardship for my nation, I would have ordered them to use miswak for every prayer that they go to. That hadith is now sahihu li ghayrihi, because it came in more than one narration. It came, it now moved up to what? It moved up to hasanun and sahihu li ghayri. It moved up to what? Sahihu li ghayri. The chain that supported it is the chain narrated by Bukhari. This chain, as I mentioned, is Muhammad ibn Amr, narrated from An-Nabi Salamata, An-Nabi Hurairata, That's the three. Bukhari brought another chain of narration, which is Abi Zinad an al-A'raj an Abi Huraira. Abi Zinad an al-A'raj an Abi Huraira. You see, so who's parallel to Muhammad ibn Amr? Who is parallel to Muhammad ibn Amr ibn al-Qamata? Abi Zinad. Abi Zinad is the one who is parallel to him. So Abi Zinad is min ruwat al-Bukhari. It's from Shuyukh al-Bukhari. It's from the ruwat of Bukhari in the chain, the men of Bukhari narrating in Sahih. Strong narrator. So now this hadith got supported. So this hadith became what? Sahih li-ghayri. So lastly, Sahih li-ghayri, it is hasan li-dhati idha ruwiya min tariqin akhara. It is when that hasan li-dhati is narrated different chains of narrations like it or higher than it. Like it or higher than it. Now the Shaykh rahimahullah, he's going to speak about if the hadith hasan and sahih is mentioned together. Because now you know what sahih means and you know what hasan means. Right, if they're mentioned together. Especially the way Imam al-Tirmidhi makes it. He says hadithun hasanun sahih. What does it mean? Because they're two different things. So why would he say it together? So we're going to take it. فَإِن جُمِعَا, if they're both mentioned together. جُمِعَا means what? If they're both mentioned together, he means sahih and hasan are both mentioned together. فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ حَيْثُ التَّفَرُّدُ. So for two reasons. The Hajar is telling you two reasons. The first one is فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ. There is a taraddud. Taraddud means what? Taraddud means the
hesitation
that occurs from the author of the book. He's not sure whether the hadith is hasan or whether the hadith is sahih. There's a taraddud. There is what do you say?
Hesitation.
Yeah, hesitation. He doesn't know which opinion to take. He's not sure, and that will only happen. If the chain of narration is one. That can only happen if the chain of narration is what? Is one. He thinks he doesn't know which one this is. Is this hadith hasan or is this hadith sahih? That is أَيَّرْوِ الْحَدِيثَ بِإِسْنَادٍ وَاحِدٍ وَإِلَّا فَبِإِعْتِبَارِ إِسْنَادَيْنِ. But if the chain has two, and then author like Tirmidhi says حَدِيثٌ حَسَنٌ صَحِيحٌ, he means one of the chain is sahih and one of the chain is hasan. That's what he means. But if the chain is one, we find out after research that the chain is one, then what we say is that the hadith is, the author of the book is unsure. He's trying to say that according to some of the muhaddithin, they consider the hadith sahih, and some of the muhaddithin, they consider the hadith hasan. فَبِالنِسْبَةِ إِلَيَّ, according to me, لَمْ يَتَرَجَّحْ لَدَيَّ, it hasn't become clear to me, الْحُكْمُ بِإِحْدَاهِمَا. Which one of it is this? Is it sahih or hasan? That's the first one. Or, if the chain has, if the hadith has more than one chain, which is it's two, then what the author of the book is trying to say is that the hadith is, according to each of the chain, it takes one of the two. So, the description of it being hasan goes to one of the chain, and sahih goes to the other chain. So that's what Ibn Hajar mentions. Some of the ulama, they added a third one to it, which is that the hasan that's used here is it's meant by lughawi, dun al-istilahi. It's meant linguistically, not technically. What do we mean linguistically? We mean the hasan in terms of it being beautiful and good, and not the definition of the muhaddithin when they say the hadith is hasan. So what he's trying to say is anna lafdhu hasan, that the wording is hasan. Beautiful wording, nice wordings, because they're trying to say that that the usage of the ruling here is very easy for the people, and Allah has made it easy for them. So it's as though they're trying to say that, but not looking at the chain. Okay, Ibn Salah rahimahullah, one of the great muhaddithin we spoke about last time in his kitab Ulum al-Hadith, he said إِنَّ غَيْرَ مُسْتَنْكَرْ, that view is not rejected. It's not غير مستنكر. And there are other answers that were given, but we don't want to go into too much details. وهناك أجوبة أخرى لا نطيل بذكرها, in which we do not want to go too much into. Now.